It's the NFL on EA Sports, and the question is, are you ready for some football? It's the Niners and the Commanders coming up next.
It's a pretty frigid December day in our nation's capital. We got our space heaters on full blast up in the booth at FedEx Field. Today we've got an intriguing NFC matchup lined up here, as it'll be the San Francisco 49ers taking on the Washington Commanders. With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. CD, these Commanders, a last place ball club in 2022. Well, in most cases, you'd say that was a lost season, but they finished 8-8-1, 500. That would have won the NFC South. What kind of a chance do you give them in what is certainly a loaded NFC East?
And you're exactly right about the division, so you have to be cautious about what you think with this team. They've got to continue to play excellent defense and get some improvement on the offensive side of the ball and establish who their quarterback is going to be.
Then for the visiting 49ers, you know, they're exciting on the offensive side of the ball, but it's the defense that really provides a lot of stability. They were second by a whisker to the Bills in total defense a year ago.
And they have all pro caliber players at all three levels, all capable of taking over a game.
The veteran Joey Sly set to get us started, and we are underway in our nation's capital. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. The Niners offense set to go to work, and it's last year's revelation, Brock Purdy, who leads him out in season number two from Iowa State.
And there's a word that constantly gets thrown around with this guy when you talk to anyone in the building. Potential. They are sky high on what they believe he can grow into in the role of a starting quarterback. In addition, there are plenty around the league who think that as well. And years from now, he can still be leading this offense out.
First play, and Purdy wants to throw it. It's caught by Jennings. The game's first play produces 6 yards, brings up second down. Out of the gun, Purdy. Over the middle, complete to Samuel. And Debo going to have a Niners first down as the tackle made up near the 35. It's a 7-yard gain there, and it's good enough to move the chains. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Purdy. He'll get this underneath to McCaffrey. The result, only 4 yards there on the play, and that'll make it second down.
Well, offensively, that's the mismatch that you want. You want to force a linebacker to try and cover your back out of the backfield, out in some open space. But linebackers nowadays, they run like backs, and they take a lot of pride in covering. What a nice play he made there in the open field.
Here's the Pro Bowler, Christian McCaffrey. Nowhere to go that time. He maybe got a yard up to the 40. Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
They are in need of 6 yards here if they hope to move the chains. Here's Purdy now on third and goal. That's Samuel, caught left side. And he won't quite make it. He needed 6. He got about 5. Fourth down. And a good sign for them right now to have their young quarterback looking confident on the opening drive.
Now, we haven't met a young quarterback, a veteran quarterback. It doesn't matter. We haven't met a quarterback yet that doesn't tell us he's confident about his abilities, right?
That's true.
But when you're young, it's really important to get off to a good start because it does build up that confidence and allows him to play better as the game goes on.
Especially crucial here on the road. The Commanders set to go to work on offense, and they've handed the controls to this man in his second NFL season, former Tar Heel Sam Howell.
And he left North Carolina with most of his school's records, and at one point was thought to be maybe the number one quarterback in his draft class. He does bring deceptive athleticism and plenty of upside to the table. Add some consistency, and maybe he can really unlock what he can be in the NFL.
Now first and 10 here for Hal and the Commanders at their own 13. They'll try and start this drive in the air. This one complete to Curtis Samuel. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. 39 yards the distance covered on the catch and run.
As we've seen over the years, offense coordinators will often ease their way into drives. Many of them don't want to risk a turnover and put their defense in a bad spot, but not in this case.
Not at all. Forget about easing into it. They took a shot. It worked. So the line of scrimmage moves all the way across the 50 now as they come up first and 10. Now the second-year man from Alabama, it's Brian Robinson. Looking for a seam but finding none. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage and that's it. Fred Warner, the all-pro linebacker, there on the stop. Well done to sniff that out defensively. He had it diagnosed pretty quickly.
I love that description because diagnosed is perfect on that one. Read his keys, made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
This one left side caught by Gibson. And he'll go down inside the 45 before going out of bounds. He'll get only three there, so it leaves him with a third and seven ahead. So 7 yards from the first down here as they come up to the line of scrimmage. On third down, Robinson. Yeah, he'll work free from one tackle, but that's about all as he's taken down. Call it a gain of three, and it'll bring up fourth down. Now the former Oklahoma Sooner Tress Way on to punt the football. And he'll get this away into the icy winter air. And no return here. Where will they spot it? They say just outside the 20-yard line. Back out there comes the 49ers offense ready for their second drive. The crowd may be losing just a little bit of the edge after back-to-back punts.
They want some big plays. They want to see some offense. They want to see somebody break away, whether it's through the air or on the ground. Now it'll be interesting to see where the patience is on both sides. Each head coach, can you hang in there and not try and force something that could put your team in some jeopardy?
And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down, second and right at a yard. We've seen quite a bit of the short passing game here early on first quarter, haven't we?
We have, and I think it works a couple of ways for this team because, number one, you throw the short game until they stop it. And if they're not going to stop and you keep throwing it, occasionally you'll break a tackle and turn into a bigger gain. Also, if they start to creep up, start to pressure receivers, now you go over the top, take it deep, and now you get some of those big shots downfield.
And McCaffrey going to pick up a Niners first down as he'll get this up to the 34-yard line.
Second and one, and people want to run the football. This is where every back in the league is supposed to do exactly what we just saw there, pick up the first down.
From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Purdy now to throw off the play action. Well, this is taken in. It's complete. Now he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. A gain of 32 that time.
Well, partner, I'm not sure how this drive's going to end, but how about the way they flip field position there? A nice attacking play that picked up a heck of a chunk of yardage.
So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30. A handoff, McCaffrey running right. And they'll be inside the 25 now at the 24. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll bring up a second and just about a few inches here.
Now that was an excellent run. And when you see that happen, that's when you're seeing guys doing their job and then some people doing a little bit more. Offensive linemen and tight ends, they're expected to block. But the wide receivers, all they want to do is catch passes. So when they block on a big-time running play and create extra space, you've kind of hit the jackpot there.
And on this one, he'll get to the 15, right at the 15-yard line. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down. The first drive this unit had, they punted. This drive, much more polished, just looking crisper, aren't they, moving the ball.
Maybe the first drive was a little bit of a wake-up call. Probably a little bit angry that they had to punt the ball away the first time they had it. Got motivated, got to the sideline, said, okay, let's not let that happen here as we take over again.
No score after one on EA Sports. The 49ers with the football here to begin the second quarter. Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10. As they've got it as we resume action. They'll get this to Jennings over the middle. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves them with 2 to go on second down. Second and 2. First down marker at the 5-yard line. Now a give, right side McCaffrey. And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. A 5-yard gain there makes it first and goal.
Some good strong running right there, some power and some explosiveness just about got him into the end zone.
Here we go now on first and goal. Oh, how about this call down near the goal line? And he's going to get this back to the 3-yard line and no further. No gain on the play that time, and it sets up second and goal.
Brandon, if I wanted to run the football this close to the goal line, I think I'd just turn around and hand it to my tailback. Too many things could go wrong in this situation. I think they're fortunate just to get back to the line of scrimmage.
Now Samuel, and he is going to lose yardage here. That's a big loss of 3, and it brings up third down.
I like the idea to mix it up from time to time because, let's face it, you can't be predictable. But the execution was a little lacking on this one, right? You might want to go back to the drawing board with that call.
This has been a long drive. You got to figure a field goal would be a letdown. Can they convert now on third and goal? Purdy looking to throw. And this is going to be intercepted. And the Commanders are going to take possession here. It's a touchback, and they'll take over at the 20-yard line. Charles, one thing that he referenced to us yesterday was his confidence fitting the ball into any window, but obviously that window was a little too tight, and it was closing in a hurry.
And he was talking to us about having anticipation in making those types of throws. Down near the goal line, I don't think you can anticipate it as much as you need to see it open. You've got to be precise with your throws down here in the red zone. That one goes into double coverage, and he gets picked off.
They'll throw on first down. Here's Howell. Got this complete to Jahan Dotson. And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down. Up at the 29 now, they'll head to the line. Second and a yard. Straight ahead, it's Robinson. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down.
Second and 1 is often an invitation to take the big shot downfield. I'll bet the offensive lineman said, are you kidding? We just get on our backs and let's go get the first down. They love being physical.
From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Gibson here running out of the gun. He'll get this to about the 38.
End result of that one, a nice 4-yard gain. So you can use that to set up your play action game, or you can come right back and continue to run the football, because as an offensive play caller, you're on schedule and feeling pretty good about your next couple of calls.
Second and 6. Out of the gun, it's Howell. And this throw incomplete. Well, the defender all over him that time, and it's going to lead to third down.
As his old brain remembers, when I see five wide receivers on the field as a defender, I know the ball's coming out hot. They expected it and got there and popped it free.
So after the second down incompletion, they'll come up now against a third and six. Throwing here, Howell. Throwing quickly there, but it's incomplete. The passing game not in sync here early, and now it's fourth down.
Well, they've moved the ball okay here in these first two drives, but this one's going to again amount to nothing. They've got to start dialing up some plays that allow them to finish drives with points.
Tress Way on fourth down is sent out to punt. Fair catch called. It's taken in right at the 20-yard line. They call it 38 yards on the punt, no return. And the Niners will go on offense, first and 10. Purdy going to lead the 49ers to the line, first and 10 at the 20. Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. He'll get this out right here to McCaffrey. Now he's free at the 35 and down to the 29-yard line. A big play there on the catch and run. 51 yards.
Where's the contain there? And yes, that's a question because that was just a simple drop-off. But he hits the Jets, and all of a sudden, the seas part in front of him. A huge result there to flip the field and what was a fairly innocuous play call.
So that changes things in a big way. Now from all the way down inside the 30, here's first and 10. Connects with Kittle underneath. Down inside the 10. And all the way to the 2-yard line there before crossing over out of bounds. A big play there on the catch and run. And it'll result in a fresh set of downs.
How about the way they're moving the ball down the field? They had a big play a moment ago. Followed it up with another nice one here. And before you know it, they're already looking at first and goal.
Oh, how about this on first and goal? And he'll take this into the end zone for a San Francisco touchdown. Brandon Ayuk taking it in from 2 yards out. And the 49ers post the first points of the ball game as they take the lead here in this second quarter.
This feels like something we'd see more commonly, CD, in a college game. They give it to the receiver down here in the red zone, but it winds up successful.
Yeah, partner, I think you think it's less likely to find running space to the edge down here close to the end zone where things are so condensed. But a lot of times you end up focusing on the running backs and they're able to slip it to the receiver, and it resulted in a touchdown.
So following the touchdown, here's Moody back out to send it away.
Now it's Crowder. And his guys will get the football right at the 20-yard line. So out comes Washington's offense to take over. They'll be looking to match that touchdown from a moment ago. 7-0 is the score as they begin with a first down. Here's Gibson to start the drive. And he'll get to the 29-yard line, brought down there.
On any explosive run, you can almost feel the ground shaking, and that's from the offensive linemen creating space for their runners. I had an old coach tell me before, they always told his runners, run around the offensive line in pregame. Get used to the ground shaking so you don't trip and fall when it happens in a game.
2 minutes on the clock, second quarter, 7-0 ball game. A good gain on first has him set up with second and just a couple of inches now from the 29.
And Howell will throw it.
And he was slid to a stop. He does have the first down. They get 9 out of that one, and as a result, the drive continues.
As he came to the line of scrimmage, he knew he didn't need much to reset the chain, so when he saw the space he needed, no hesitation. He went to the marker and got his guys a first down.
First down now, but that clock rolling. Now Howell. That's going to be caught by Samuel. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. 15 yards the pickup. First down, Washington.
Thus far, it hasn't been a real fun half for them, but a play like that, that may get them off the schneid a little bit, get them loosened up and moving.
Kind of seems like they've been sleepwalking and still sitting on 0 points.
And it's not always making an adjustment. Sometimes it's just going back to what you know can work and finally getting it done.
Howell's got this one to Robinson, and he'll be brought down, it looks like, right at the 40. So they'll get 8 out of that completion, and it'll be second in a couple. Howell, he'll look to throw it. Open man is Samuel, complete. Washington now going to use the first of their 3 timeouts as the clock will stop with 34 seconds to go before halftime. Let's go, baby. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Howell down to throw it. And down he goes. The 49ers get there. Now Washington going to use the second of their 3 timeouts. So that means they're down to 1 remaining here as we head toward halftime.
Come on, let's play like a team.
Well, they're in some hot water now. After that sack, it's second and 21. Howell out of the shotgun. That's out wide here for Robinson. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. That will go as a pickup of 7 on the 7th play of the drive. A long way to go here on 3rd down for the 8th play of the drive. Howell. Throw there going to be incomplete. 4th down now as San Fran's defense was strong in coverage. Problems on 3rd down so far in this first half. Relatively small sample size, but they're now 0-for-3.
And the average in the league, somewhere around 40% on 3rd down for offenses. So what's the answer to this? Either convert them or don't get to 3rd down in the first place. Get your big chunks of yards on 1st and 2nd down.
And he has got it. From 55 yards away, that was never in doubt. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So that kick gives them their first points of the game, CD. And it comes on the 3rd drive, but hopefully for them, that's a spark that gets that offense going.
Yeah, and I would say if you're the offensive play caller, as you look at your sheet, you're trying to find that part on there that unlocks bigger points. They've struggled with a few drives so far, finally got 3 out of it. How do you find the end zone? That's what he's searching for now.
So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. And he will make it to the 20-yard line and no further. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. And with a 7-3 lead, we'll see how aggressive they want to be. And they're just going to run it here up the middle. And he'll be brought down right at the 30 here. So we've reached intermission here in a low-scoring game. 7-3 is our score. As we'll get you down the coast to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman at REA Sports Halftime Report. Coach!
All right, Brandon, back to you two in just a bit. But first, welcome everyone to downtown Orlando and our EA Sports Halftime Report. We were certainly treated to an entertaining first half. Both these teams with some high points and maybe a couple of low points as well. So it's going to be a question of who can be the most disciplined team going forward.
Okay, Coach, thanks as always. This one's still anyone's game as we welcome you back for quarter number three. Washington down on the scoreboard, but they are getting the football first here, and we are back underway on EA Sports. This fielded right at the goal line. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. The Washington offense ready to go to begin the third quarter. But Charles, we saw pretty entertaining first half, close ball game. Remember there toward the end of the second quarter, the opposition scored to take the lead. Now we'll see if these guys can get a score of their own to regain that lead.
Yeah, they want to have that type of a response, don't they? Because they want to find a way to take control of this ball game one more time. Gauntlet's been thrown down. They want to see if they're ready to answer it.
Second half begins with a run by Robinson. And a good stiff arm and some space to run. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. First play of the drive, a success, 19 yards. Those are the type of runs that we did not see from him in the first half, but a good start to the third quarter.
And I know what everyone's thinking that's watching this. They did a great job adjusting at the half. Oftentimes, you don't make adjustments. You just dial into your game plan a little bit better, and maybe they're starting to make some headway.
So quickly, all the way up at the 40-yard line. Back to Robinson now on first down. And he works free. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. 40 yards rushing for him now, and he's carried the ball just five times.
We don't talk about it very often, but sometimes there's a dip in intensity when you start the second half, which can manifest itself in some sloppy tackling. And how about right there? He ran right through that weak tackle attempt.
First down, how to throw. Caught out left side by Robinson. And past the 35, he'll be dropped a yard or two shy of the 30. Another nice gain, 16 yards there at a first down again. I don't know what they talked about at halftime. Whatever it was, it worked. They look like a different team here in the third quarter.
Yeah, I doubt that there are very many trash cans that got kicked over, that type of a speech. I think what they did was they analyzed what worked in the first half, what didn't, and figured out a better game plan.
Powell's throw complete to Dotson. He'll be dropped at the 25 after a gain of six. So a decent gain there, but not their fourth consecutive first down like they had on the first three plays.
You sound almost disappointed there. You want to fire the offensive coordinator on that one or what?
They'd gotten into a rhythm. I thought they were just going to keep going.
Well, almost a win for the defense, but if that's your win, you're not doing very well right now.
Here's Howell. This is caught by Robinson. And he'll get it down this time to the 17. That one, a first down pickup of eight.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon. And it looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time, they pick up a first down. So now on defense, do you assign a man to him and try and cover him before he gets going?
Powell to the air on first and 10. And it's caught. Touchdown, Washington. Logan Thomas from 17 yards out. And the Commanders have taken the lead as they go right down the field and score on the opening drive of the second half.
For good reason, quarterbacks wanted to get the ball to the perimeter to their wide receivers for big plays. But in this situation, it felt like, based on coverage, he knew that he wanted his tight end to have the football, and for good reason.
Joey Sly on for the extra point. And it's through, and that makes the lead 10-7.
So the drive there took six plays. And it was capped off by the Logan Thomas touchdown catch. Joey Sly now to kick off after the touchdown. And he'll decide to not bring this one out as their drive will begin at the 25. Here's a look at the 49ers offense as they make their way out for their first possession of the second half. Purdy going to lead the 49ers to the line, first and 10 at their 25-yard line. The play action fake. They'll look to throw. That's complete. It's Brandon Ayuk. And they work this well upfield across the 45. A good pickup there, 21 yards.
Certainly no settling into the drive there. They came right out on the first play and attacked the middle of the field for a big gainer and a first down.
A big hitter to start the drive has him up near midfield here for first and 10. McCaffrey running up the middle. And he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here, second down.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
From the 48-yard line, here's the second and 8. They stay on the ground. McCaffrey again. A yard in the wrong direction makes third down tougher. Third down and 9. And yet again, this run game just continues to be completely shut off.
Completely stymied. Right? They're trying to get some consistency, trying to find places to roam. They just haven't been there throughout this game.
Third down now. Those last two plays indicative of how things have gone for them. Just nowhere to go on the ground and struggling to put up points. Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And they're going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at Washington's 38-yard line. They give him 14 yards that time and a fresh set of downs.
And it's pretty evident that this passing game has been frustrated so far. They haven't really moved the ball the way we might have expected, but this is a good pickup here for the first down.
In Washington territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 38. Here's Samuel. Flash the stick skills, but didn't get a ton from it. Stopped short of the 35. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9. They'll give it up to McCaffrey. They juked him. There he goes, right side. And that one opened up for him well as he'll take this down to the 26-yard line. 50 yards on the ground for him now on 9 carries.
First downs have not come easy, and neither have runs like this throughout this game.
Absolutely not. He finally felt like, whoa, a sigh of relief. We got something going in the running game.
Purdy to throw it on first down. That's to the right side, complete to Kittle. And he's out of bounds, almost gets to the 10. 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down.
They're just going to run a drive route here with their tight end. Let him get upfield about 10 yards, and then move toward the middle of the field. This ball's right on target, and it results in a first down.
On first down, this is McCaffrey. And he'll take this one inside the 10, down to the 8. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
That run wasn't a big breaker, but I don't think the guys on offense mind very much. They've got a nice drive going, and they might just be luring the defense in a little bit. They could probably come back with a play action, maybe go over the top. But right now, on this drive, their playbook is open.
Throwing on second down, it's Purdy. Got a man right side, it's McCaffrey. And inside the five here before he's out of bounds right at the three. A gain of three last play. This time they double it and pick up six. On third down, it's Purdy. Is caught. For the moment, it's a touchdown, but multiple flags down, so let's sort this out. So reverse the celebration. We'll see if they have something else in their bag of tricks.
And isn't that always tough to watch when they score and you see the excitement, and then when they realize those points aren't going to count? Can they get it back together and find their way back to the end zone?
Back now at FedEx Field. It's been a very hotly contested game to this point. Just a field goal separating these two teams as we get set for the fourth quarter. And his kick here is good. And in the fourth quarter, this game is tied. I tell you, the life of a kicker. He has not been called on the entire game. He's over there by the net, but they send him out here in the fourth quarter and say, hey, go tie the game, will you? And guess what? He comes through.
I just don't know how they do it. I really don't. These cats are a different breed from you and me. That's a pressure kick, but that one was never in doubt.
Now this one setting up for a great finish. All tied in the fourth as the kick's away. But a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. Now we get another look at Washington on offense. And we essentially have a brand new ball game. After that last field goal has tied us all up, we brace for what should be an exciting rest of this fourth quarter. Howell and the Commanders come up now, first and 10, right at the 30. He'll start with a give to Robinson, and he can only manage to get a couple. Second and 8 coming up. And that one was relatively easy to see. I noticed that from up here.
Yeah, it doesn't take a whole lot, does it? Sometimes you get multiples. What I always love on these offsides is when each side points at the other. Hey, you did it. No, you did it. They deciphered that one correctly.
So this helps to start a drive. After the penalty, it'll be first and 5. Robinson up the middle. And he'll get 2, maybe 3 up near the 37.
Not a whole lot there after the penalty, but remember, it was first and 5, not first and 10. So now they can keep grinding out first downs and good things can happen for them. Just second and short coming up.
So from the 37, here's second down and 2. Little bootleg here, Howell. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down.
This has certainly been a physical game so far. Limited scoring opportunities for both sides. And there's another chance that goes unfulfilled.
This offense so far on third down, 0 for 3 to this point. They could use a conversion. This time they face a third and 2. Able to find the open man. That's complete. Some space to operate. And he has a big gain inside the 40 before being dropped. A big play that time on the catch and run. And it'll give him a fresh set of downs.
And Brandon, from our time in college football, where receivers weren't running the traditional NFL route tree, one thing they did learn, find open areas, find soft spots, and set up and catch the ball. And I think we just saw that there.
Yeah, we saw that indeed, picking up the first. On first and 10, it's Gibson. It's a 6-yard pickup, but it gets him to second and 4.
That play wasn't quite as big as the play that preceded it, but still, Gotta like the way they're moving the football, partner.
Absolutely. Pretty good room to run on that last play.
Yeah, they didn't get a first down, but still, you'll take runs like that each and every time, won't you?
From the 32-yard line now, here's a second down and 4. Now they go play action with Howell. And that'll be off the mark, too far out in front, and it's incomplete. He shook his head right when he released that throw. He knew it was going to be a little off target.
Yeah, the excitement got him on that one. Wasn't able to control the fact the receiver was open, and it would have been an easy throw.
A field goal try would be almost 50 yards from this spot. So what can they do to get closer now on third down? Back to throw. Howell.
Was awfully tight there on third down. They actually closed off all the passing lanes, forcing the incompletion and bringing up fourth down.
So now one of the biggest kicks of the night is forthcoming. This to break our fourth quarter tie. Sly able to put this one through, and they will take the lead at 13-10. So the drive here ends with a field goal. It does give them the lead, but this one's still certainly a long ways from over.
It definitely puts a lot of pressure on your defense to hold the lead, right? They're happy to have it and happy to be out there trying to do so. But I know as a former player, in the back of their mind, they're thinking, why don't you score the touchdown and seal this thing?
After the made field goal, here's Sly to kick this one away. And they'll put up the stop sign there as his guys will get it at the 25. Out on the field now, here come the 49ers. And now they find themselves trailing following the field goal. Still a good amount of time in this fourth quarter, but this drive very well could determine the outcome of this ball game. Purdy going to lead the 49ers to the line, first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. On play action, they'll throw. And that one into the hands of Ayuk downfield. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. Getting it to him in space pays off big time. That winds up going for 31.
Despite writing it down on my notes, I never give enough credit to the offensive line, and we have to here. The protection, that's what made this play a success. Quarterback had to wait for his crossing route to develop, and that takes a little bit of extra time. Excellent job by the big fellas up front.
So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. Purdy will set up to throw it here. Slant route connects with Deebo Samuel. And he's going to get this down near the 30-yard line. That's over 40 yards of movement with those last two plays.
And here we are in the fourth quarter, partner, and watch them drive for what would be a go-ahead touchdown. And you and I both know this is where you need a quarterback who can keep his cool back there, not just for himself, but to keep the rest of the team relaxed too.
Play action, and now here's Purdy to throw it. To give you an idea of how accurate he's been throwing the football, we're in the second half. That's just his second incompletion.
Well, if he's that locked in, that means everyone's locked in, because to me it's like throwing a no-hitter in baseball. The pitcher may get the credit, but a lot of people making plays behind him in the field.
Here's second and 10. Once more, Purdy looking to throw. To the sideline, and wow, what a catch there. He doesn't get a lot, but he was able to get the feet down complete. 5 yards, now it's third and 5.
Let's make this one simple. What a catch, especially the finishing part of getting his feet in bounds, toe tapping, and of course, foot dragging.
A little tapestry, if you will.
Oh, I like it.
Purdy now to throw. And that is incomplete.
We're going to give out a little applause on that play. It has to go to the defense. More good work by them. They've taken away the passing lanes all game long, and you can see the frustration that it's causing because he just about threw that one into the first row.
And his kick is right there. It's good. And in the fourth quarter, this game is tied. Well, you talk about clutch. That one was right down Broadway, and this game's all even here in the fourth.
Yeah, he didn't leave any doubt, did he? Good snap, good hold, dead center. Almost like a big-time golfer in a major, firing at a pin from the fairway, trying to win the tournament going down the stretch.
Now this one setting up for a great finish, all tied in the fourth as the kick's away.
Now it's Crowder.
And no alley to be found. The coverage was solid, and he's dropped at the 18. Now here we go on the next drive for Washington.
And after the field goal last time, we'll see what they can get here. At least they got points out of the last drive, Charles.
I never met an offensive coach that didn't want a drive to end with a kick. Most of them want it end with a PAT, right? In this case, a field goal, they'll take it. Way better than the alternative, which is a punt.
Yeah, but you met fan bases that wanted that, that weren't happy with that field goal.
I haven't met a fan base yet that wants a drive to end with a kick, other than the extra point. That's it.
52 yards rushing for him now in the ball game.
What a way to start a drive. An excellent run, a tone setter, and now, if you want to take a shot on second down and go play action and make it look like the same exact play and throw it over the top, you can do so because you've established the run in a big way.
Short throw there, caught by Thomas.
He had the touchdown earlier. This one's going to get him a first down. That tight end position, it just seems to continue to evolve every year in the NFL.
Yeah, you're getting really terrific athletes. A lot of them maybe were wide receivers at one point. They continue to give you speed, great hands, and big bodies, which make them excellent targets for quarterbacks.
On first down, Howell.
That's complete to his receiver, McLaurin. Yeah, he's corralled at the 40, but not before picking up 8.
Fired that one in there, able to make connection on a nice in route.
With those faster passes when they're going that fast, any hesitation as a quarterback that the deflection, if you miss, might be bigger and lead to an interception?
Yeah, and the deflection works both ways. Maybe a defender gets a hand in the way and it pops in the air, and sometimes you throw it so hard your receiver can't handle it, and he pops it up in the air for the defenders to grab as well.
But a moot point there as they were able to connect. Pretty good job defensively. Thought he was going to get it, but they knew where that marker was, and they stopped him just short of it.
What it does is emphasize that strategic football and situational football is not just played on the offensive side, is it? Defense understanding, as you noted, where the first down marker was and making sure they didn't get there.
So it's Commanders football as we get back to it. But just a gigantic play here, both sides. This is 3rd and inches.
And he's got the first down, yardage before being taken down at midfield.
And now time will be called here as Washington has an injured player down on the field. So as the medical staff takes a look, we'll step aside. Plenty of time and 2 timeouts still at their disposal. 1st and 10 here. Here's Howell. Short throw here, the tight end Bates.
And he's able to get this to the 40-yard line before he's out of bounds.
It certainly feels like there are more stars at the tight end position than there were even 10 years ago. And I think it's become more of a glamour position because of the ways it can hurt a defense, and guys want to be involved. They can be in line, close to the line of scrimmage. They can split out like receivers. But hands, route running, speed, and some toughness to go across the middle, you put it all together, you got a heck of a tight end candidate. Partner, they're clearly saving those timeouts, but they still have to work with some urgency to put themselves in the right position.
They'll come up 1st and 10 here. Robinson with another carry.
And he'll go down at the 28. The 49ers now going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. On the give, here's Robinson. And a hard-working run here as he's got it inside the 20, down to the 17. Now San Francisco going to call their second timeout. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. Hand off to Robinson out of the shotgun. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down.
Let's go do this thing, baby. That's what it is. That's what it is, baby.
We are gonna do this. We got this.
Here's second and a yard. Out of the gun, they give to Robinson. And he'll be brought down this time at the 5-yard line.
Sometimes I get almost mesmerized watching these runners who have great vision. You know, those eyes that carry their feet to open spaces, make people miss. I just love watching those guys go to work.
Now first and goal. They'll run with Robinson, and they'll be driven back here, losing yardage to the 9.
Well, they would have loved to have scored a touchdown there, but this still sets them up for a game-winning field goal attempt.
The Commanders going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 11 seconds remaining in the ball game. So the field goal unit is on the field as this is a big spot right here. This to almost certainly win the football game. And his kick is good. And it's celebration time on that sideline as they have taken the lead in the final seconds. The home crowd here absolutely loves it, as they should, getting the field goal in the closing moments and likely going to get out of here with a W.
A W, celebrations all around. How about how everyone's going to leave this stadium, right? And you know something? He probably makes more money than most of the 60,000 people here, but they're all willing to buy him dinner tonight, aren't they?
Oh, they don't care. He's a man of the people right now. After the made field goal, here's Sly to kick this one away. And he returns this to the 22. Purdy with one final shot here. Finding Samuel. And he'll be taken down, but not before they reach the 50. Well, it took us until the final play, Charles, to officially decide a winner. Although on that last play, they were so backed up, it would have taken a miracle, and they couldn't get that miracle done.
Well, I like how you stayed with it, because we both knew that this had to go down to the last play, and neither side was going to exhale until that play concluded, because we've seen the improbable before. A couple of laterals, maybe some poor defense on the back end. They might have gone all the way to the end zone. In this case, though, it didn't happen. Perhaps next time.
So that'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our crew, I'm Brandon Gunn. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. The Commanders pick up the victory as we say so long from our nation's capital.